today's plan, loot stuff, and dodge and kill dogs. Again, if you are, for whatever reason, severely underarmed, you don't even have like a pistol or a shotgun at this point and are not comfortable going out on dog day, by all means don't. You can still be mining underground. You can be, you know, crafting stuff here if you're not caught up on that. You can do a number of things. So don't feel like you're a terrible person if you don't want to head out at this point. Fiddle around with some flaming arrows later. I really didn't need to bring the wrench along because I'm not really planning on trying to dismantle a bunch of cars today. Dismantling cars will generally fill up your inventory very quickly, and yeah, you can throw away all the scrap iron and iron pipes and such that you get. On the flip side, if you're going to dismantle a bunch of cars, it's kind of like, why not try to hang on to it? Do not feel like you are obliged to do melee fighting like this. If you are not comfortable, adjusted, or don't have medical supplies, etc., I'm just showing you what you can do with a decent melee weapon. And hunting knife on the default difficulty works perfectly fine for that, especially with some blade skills, which is something we may spend some points on improving. I'm not sure yet, need to decide. Notice I'm timing my approaches here. I'm not just necessarily rushing in unless I'm confident. I want them to notice me. I want the movements to be predictable. The goal is to either do enough damage to them and to kill them instantly. That's your, you know, perfect ideal. Or, worst case scenario, you do enough damage so that they get knocked on their back and then you can finish them off with a second hit. Or if you screw up like that, you take damage, and you may get infected. So, be warned, you don't really want to try this unless you're A, desperate, or B, have enough medical supplies available. That if, you know, because you will mess up, whether it's due to just the game screwing up, or you screwing up. In either case, you know, if the result's the same, you get hit. It will happen. So don't try to do a lot of dedicated melee fighting unless you know you can absorb their mistakes. Vidi is kind of that. In some cases, you may be better off with medical supplies and available antibiotics and such than you are for arrows, especially if you're having trouble hitting, trying to still learn to aim as well, or whatever. Is this a junkyard with nothing in it, or something? Anyone have any idea what this is? Because I sure don't. This is, looks like it's supposed to be a junkyard or exterior for something, but there's nothing here. We're expecting at least one more dog attack today, perhaps two. The first attack probably happened while we were down in the mines, and thus we never even saw it. One of the other nice thing about mining. See, that right there is why you don't want to rush up. Because they can sometimes, you know, alter at the last second, or maybe the game doesn't think you can cleanly hit their head. I'm gonna learn you now. remember what in here. I know there were multiple things that I wanted to be bringing back. I think that was most of it at this point, then. Well, we can grab that pistol, though I don't think Representative Father is using it, most likely. We'll grab the bones. Scrap the axe. Alrighty. Just keep working a pattern here, I guess. That'll do. It's dark enough that I prefer this. Less protection, but better visibility. Is that better than I have? Than what I have? Definitely. Should have refilled on food and water. That may actually be better than the SWAT helmet, but I'm not really sure. Because the SWAT helmet is more damaged, the tooltip is lying on that. But even if we doubled that, right? Even if we doubled that, we'd only get about 40%, so I think this is just better through sheer item quality. And both will be worse than the iron helmet. I'm not sure if it was aviator goggles or the other I'm not sure if those aviator goggles or the other aviator goggles are better, but don't think it's really worth taking them back to be sure right now. Is that all there is in here? Huh. I feel gypped. When we go into wrench mode, we'll be collecting springs and stuff in places like this. But we're not there yet. There's no downstairs in here. And there's the dogs. Hey, dogs. Reinforcements will be incoming in a moment. Come on, where are you? Doggy over here. How is that? What? Are you serious? I would have sworn I hit that dog multiple times in the face there, but I guess not. Should have been more careful on the aiming. Shotgun that I did just out of exasperation, of course, then destroyed a chunk of the hides that I could have gotten. So I took 20 damage and have an infection, but I guess that's all the dogs. I thought there'd be more. You notice how they ran past without even noticing until they're like right on top of me though. That's really annoying when that happens. Maybe maybe weird if you, like, you're saying, notice me, so you start growling, please. And notice me so you don't, like, nearly run past me and then suddenly beeline over to me. But actually see me and be on an attack run sooner. It's easier to line up a shot. Bird's nest, this bird's nest. I don't know why that was lying there, but... If you like blueberries, feel free to grab them, but if you have corn, which you already do, there's unlimited food right there. In today's Leather Duster Heaven, today's even more leather. Is there like a leather fetish that you have, pimps or something? I am willing to take that. Now if only we could get the pistol book. About to have the airdrop incoming, so I need to make sure I'm outside at noon. Gonna drop like right on top of our base too, so I guess we can refill on water and all while we're there. Checking the ammunition status of everything, making sure we're good there. Avoiding the bear for the moment, since we are more worried about the supply crate. I would like to know is why they couldn't do this every time for the airdrop. Maybe if we make like a giant sign on the ground that says like airdrop here, they'll do that, right? I mean, seriously, look at this. Look at this. It's right next to our freaking base. Why couldn't they do this each time? But of course, if you're at our base, they'd drop it in town. We have honey, which I prefer to use for this. Eggs we don't really care about. Beaker we technically don't really need, but Auger schematically, no. Sniper, we couldn't scrap those earlier. But now we can. Medical supplies go here. Some food supplies go here. So we have... How many steel arrows do we have? 22. That just makes 22 tallow. Did we ever plant any golden rods? I don't think we did. I think we have a few. Maybe? No, no golden rods. Pistol thing after all, I was thinking it might be useful. Cylinder. And we'll put our other pistol here for now. Shotgun stock. Yeah, ours is slightly better. Yeah, that should have gone like that. AK-47 parts. Rocket launcher stock. Now we have two of those. We are going to need some gunpowder, plus the tallow. Those arrows have melted, yeah. That was apparently not on. Neither of them were on. I only turned on the main one, because I'm a genius. Bow before me. Last time I fiddled with flaming arrows, I tried them out briefly. I was really not impressed with them, so we're giving them a second chance here since we still are using a bow. We'll see if we can actually make any use out of them. My hunch is that the answer is going to be no, but never let it be said. I didn't give things a chance to prove their worth. Thank you. I suppose goldenrod doesn't grow in this biome at all, does it? Do we have any leads on... Yeah, we have a lead on the biome over there. Two biomes over there. I don't think the snow... Well, actually, the snow's not really going to help us, is it? And the burned region, I think that is, probably isn't going to help us either. So, I think we are going to just have to pick flowers for now. points do we have available? Not enough to get the next rank of knife guy. Or do we even have the base rank of knife guy? We do. But if we spent 11 on that, that'd leave us 3, which is not sufficient, so... some goldenrods up here. Did we just use all the ones nearby, or am I just going insane? Or both, you know, let's not discount every possibility. So we can plant those on our way back tonight. Maybe I just did, in fact, use up all the goldenrod earlier that I gathered from nearby. I really don't know. I'm really not sure if there's some RNG involved in these hides or not. I think that's the best receiver we have found yet. Still iron here, sadly. You'll notice that I'm immediately running past them, since if I'm moving they have an extremely difficult, if not downright impossible time to hit me. That was bad. But on the flip side, if I try to stand there in the doorway and adjust, then I'm kind of begging to get smacked. No. I'm just working my way north to south along each line right now, just for consistency's sake. I'm also expecting another set of dogs soon. Someday I'll find a pistol or magnum book. There might be a dog hitting something. I don't know if you can hear it. Oh no, it's just these guys trapped in that. Is that terrible? No, sir. That is an insult. It's an interesting psychology experiment. I think it's called the ultimatum game, is the technical term. The idea is that, you know, there are two people, player A and player B. Person C comes along and says, player A, I will give you just $100 to split between you and player B. However, after you tell player B what you want to split it at, if player B decides they don't want to do the deal, then neither of you gets anything. So you have to come up with something that's acceptable to player B. So if player A says, I'm going to keep all $100 and player B gets nothing, you would expect player B to say, excuse me, why in the world would I just let you take that money, you know, when you could have made a deal that gave some to me. But then, we had a slight abnormality. Traditional economics assumes everyone is a rational agent and acts completely rationally at all times. By that logic, hey, there's one of the things we still need. That's a better barrel, too. But it's low enough on quality that I'm not going to use it quite yet. By that logic, if player A says, I will give you $1 and keep 99 for myself, economically speaking, rationally speaking, you should say, oh, well, if I say no, then I don't have any, you know, don't get anything. If I say yes, I get a dollar. That's better than nothing, right? So therefore, I should take it. Now, likely you are already recoiling at that thought, and so do most people, because the basic idea is we think, hey, wait a second, that jackass is being a jerk and trying to rip us off and take advantage of us, you know. Even if it means that I have to give up that dollar I'm going to get right here, I'm not going to put up with that. I'm not going to stand for that. I'm going to say, you know, screw you, I don't take the deal, even if I would, strictly speaking, be better off by taking the deal. And do it again. I should probably talk less in combat. But, and that is borne out in experiments with this, that instinctive feeling we have, you know, is indeed how most people act, that they will say, you know, they won't necessarily demand a perfectly fair deal. They might not demand it be split 50-50. But if it's like less than, say, 30% for them, they'll just basically say no just to punish the other person. I think the term... So you see how she dodged under that right there? That was annoying. You are not dodging underneath that, no. I learned my lesson right there. Did we get everything in here? I think we did, right? This is where we came out for the airdrop. And if you're wondering, okay, so how did we get on that topic in the first place? It was the 12 quality mini bike wheels that I'm like, hell no, I'm not going to take that. Obviously, in this case, it's really projection because the wheels don't care and it's just code written by the pimps, but the idea is kind of like that's just such an insulting offer that I'm just going to refuse out of principles just to spite, you know, just out of a principle's sake to spite you. And if that seems decidedly irrational to you, then you wind actually up with the fact that overall it actually probably is a very rational thing to do. Why? Because if people expect people to refuse such horrible offers, if they know that trying to say, here, I'll give you $1 and I'll keep 99, that the other person's going to go, hell no, then that encourages people to actually act in a manner that will not do that. They will actually try to offer fairer deals. It may not still be perfectly fair, but it'll be fairer. I'm just debating whether it's worth taking that, then we pop up with a even better wrench. Because we already have one wrench. I'm like, probably take a second, because we can't make them yet, I guess. Come on. No, not what I wanted. Come on. No, not what I wanted. Well, even if the game won't give me some of the specific stuff I like, He's just being decent enough to give us lots of paper for shotgun shells, which we do have. And I will be, you know, to be fair, it's usually that I have, like, the Magnum book already, and I'm happy about that. But I don't have the calipers, and or I can't find the shotgun schematic, which I would also like. So now I have the shotgun schematic, so I'm going to try not to complain too much. Two 600 quality barrels. I think there's a gun safe in here, yeah. We may have to leave some stuff behind. And then we need to get back. That we can bring that. This means we can take this and combine that with the parts and open up a slot if we need to. Well, we also want to do this, now didn't we? Our goal is to get back to base and try to plant the goldenrod seeds on the way if we can. Which I think we'll be able to. We'll see. I probably should have made sure it was well on the way out of town by the 2100 mark. Just keeping the light on and a shotgun ready in case the dog swarm appears.
Stubborn entered channel.
Hey, wow. Stubborn, what's up?
Not much, how are you?
Doing alright. Recording, as you might have guessed. Want to do something?
I'm just now starting to match, but we can talk afterwards. Didn't mean to interrupt your recording.
No, it's perfectly fine. It's not that you could distract me. Oh god, the dogs are on me! You killed me, Stubborn, by distracting me!
Well then good, I mean, then it would be worth it.
It is actually dog day, day 19 in the video. The good news is I have a shotgun and a pistol, so... And yes, you can kill them with a bow if necessary and some spikes and etc. But not for people who are new and trying to learn the game, I don't really want to be necessarily encouraging them to be trying to improve their bow skills by dodging six dogs in a pack.
I get it, you suck.
Thank you for putting it succinctly, Stubborn. So we're not going to bother with this tonight. I'm going to grab another glass of water, and as standard practice, we'll leave this running just cuz. we didn't manage to plant the goldenrod seeds, and that's a shame. And what is our hand doing with the shotgun? Holy cow. Okay, that's better. So, pistol receiver, we can't adjust yet, pistol barrel. Leaves us actually at a pretty decent quality hunting rifle we can assemble, doesn't it? Ooh, right, pistol parts. Multiple 600s of those. And then we wanted to swap in the new barrel, and that's it for now. Through like a, not just weapons but also ready tools and such probably in the weapons crate. Some more chrysanthemum, other stuff finishes. Are we done with the leather? Almost, maybe, I think. Almost. Any second now. Any second now. Wow, we have a lot more available than I realized we would. Seeds. We'll be using those early on tomorrow. We don't have a blood draw kit yet, sadly. How much cement mix did we have? We had 3,000, okay. We have a lot of that, okay, good. I was concerned we might not have enough for some projects, and we... Well, saying we definitely do would be an understatement, I suppose. So... let's see what we can get. Output. Shall we?
So, did you get a chance to try Overwatch last night?
Yeah, I got a gamer 2 in only. I did like the tutorial stuff, and I did a game versus the AI once. And then I was late enough that I just went to sleep.
Yeah. I certainly don't blame you, especially this part of the semester. I gotta feed my cats here. But if you wanna come be bad with me, I'm gonna play some Overwatch. Or yeah. Rather, if you wanna come watch me be bad. I should say, be new with me and watch me be bad. There you go. That's most accurate.
You mean, least offending to your own ego.
To your ego, maybe. I'm the one saying I'm bad. That's not offending to my ego.
I'm just saying calling yourself generous is... calling yourself bad is generous, stubborn.
I see.
It's nearly 1 a.m. on this video, so I'm going to just wrap up the night, and then I'll stop.
Yeah, no problem.
and found out some data looking in the loot XML files based on what a comment somebody made on the forums. As far as I can interpret it, and I will freely acknowledge I may be wrong on this because it is not explicitly as clear as it should be and it's not actual code, it's almost like trying to read a spreadsheet somebody wrote that something else interprets, right? So you're like, so I see the data you put there in the order you put it, but I can't actually see what's then reading the spreadsheet, so I don't know how to interpret certain things about it. But, as far as I can tell,
in journalism, this is known as burying the lead.
Until you hit level 97, you have a 1% chance to see a 300-plus quality item.
Jesus, without Quality Joe?
Without Quality Joe, yeah. If you have Quality Joe and Scavenging, you can add 150 onto the, you know, the number. But you literally have a 1% chance to find a 300-plus quality, or 301-plus quality item, technically, until level 97, at which point you jump up to a 38% chance to find a 300-plus quality item.
So then, Scavenger Joe is... Not Scavenger Joe. Quality Joe is not recommended, it's required.
If you want something above, like, 100 quality early on, yeah.
And if you aren't able to craft everything you need by the time you're 90. That seems... I feel like the whole scavenging side of the game is completely unbalanced.
I completely agree, and I've been making a few posts about that lately on the forums as well. And a guy was like, you know, I don't like to grind stuff, you know, it feels like it ruins the immersion. And I made a post saying something like, you know, I don't disagree, but what also ruins my immersion is when I get a airdropped supply crate that has a military-grade sniper rifle in it that's 150 quality and can't hit a zombie on a body shot 20 yards away. Like, that doesn't make any sense.
It literally fell out of the plane. It wasn't an airdrop.
Oh, right.
From the air.
Right, right. You know, it's like, there's no way you'd have a military sniper-grade sniper rifle that was that shitty, and it makes no sense that if you go and scavenge, you're a master scavenger, right? You know all the places to find the loot. You've earned it naturally through sweat and blood and tears. And I build a base and mine some shit and craft some weapons, and then I go and find stuff that's like twice as good as the stuff you find, because zombie magic?
Right. Yeah, they definitely need to balance both the XP gain and the skill increase from the entire combat and scavenging side of the game, either by moving it up or moving the other side down. Honestly, it would slow it down a lot, but I really think they need to move the other side down. You shouldn't be level, I'm just making up a number here, 20 by the end of day 2 or 3 because you've been shitting out a lot of blocks.
Well, I think part of the problem is that if they didn't make it so, like, level 97 was required to get, like, 300 plus items at any frequency, then it wouldn't be as big of a deal.
300 plus is not a big deal. Both you and I can have, like, 300 plus tools and bows before the end of the first day.
Exactly.
If we found a safe place to stay and didn't have to build from scratch.
Exactly, but if you want to find a 300-plus quality, like, wrench, you know, that you find or have a better chance... Oh, here's another thing. Apparently, as far as I can tell, every 50 levels, your chance to go find something goes up by, like, 25%. So if you're looking for calipers... Now, as far as I can tell, and again, take this with a bit of a grain of salt, potentially. If you open a working stiff's crate... there's a 50% chance there's going to be a calipers in it, okay?
Okay.
But, if you are between level 1 and 50, you have a 25% chance after that 50% chance is applied. So you really only have a 12.5% chance of finding the calipers. If you're between level 51 and 100, you have a 50% applied. So you only have a 25% chance to find the calipers.
Wait a second. So they're stacking their percentages in a way that's reducing them?
Yeah, there's like a chance for the calipers, and then that's apparently reduced further if you're not like level... At 151 plus, apparently you have the full 50% chance or something. But if you are lower level, every 50 levels, you know, it subtracts 25% from that 100% chance. So at level 101, you have a 50% chance to qualify if you already meet the 50% chance for like the calipers or something. Or 75, I guess, at that point.
That's what's needed for the bullet shells, or?
It's needed for steel arrowheads, steel arrowheads, which are both for steel arrows and steel bolts. It's needed for every type of shell except shotgun shells. So pistol ammo, SMG ammo, hunting rifle ammo, sniper rifle ammo, magnum ammo, AK-47 ammo, every single gun uses it. Except shotguns. Well, technically shotguns too, if you want to make shotgun slugs instead of shells.
Silly.
And then the books is, instead of it being a 25% jump every 50 levels, apparently it's a 20% jump every 40 levels. So at level 41, you're, like, if you qualify to, you know, if you roll well enough to get a book in the first place, the game then does another roll and says, oh, you're below level 40, you only have a 20% chance to actually get the book now. If you're level 41 to 80, it's a 40% chance. If you're level, you know, 81 to 120, it's a 60% chance. You know, like you said, I will be the first to acknowledge that in Alpha 13, you could, you know, you were basically, you know, as you put it, like, shitting, you know, 500, 600 quality items, you know, way too fast with, like, very little effort required. And I get that they wanted to slow that down, and I don't disagree, but right now, not only does it seem too far in the other direction, but it seems that it's completely skewed. Like, if you want to get the best scavenged items, you'd think you would be scavenging, but no, you grind levels via doing anything but scavenging, because if you scavenge stuff, then that means the stuff you actually, yeah, you know, when you go scavenging, you know, you've already looted a bunch of stuff, and you have to go even further to try to find anything. It's really dumb.
Yeah, I mean, it's basically Hole Digging Simulator 2016.
It's not just hole digging. There's spam crafting gunpowder, there's spam crafting arrowheads or clubs, there's spam crafting stone shovels, there's spam crafting wood log spikes, there's spam crafting wood frames and filling them for solely for construction point skill. And then apparently at level 129, you go up again from a 38% chance to find a 300 plus quality item to a 55% chance, I think. And at that breakpoint, at that level 97, it goes from a 1% chance to find a 301 to 600 quality into actual individual segments, like, 3% chance for a 500 to 600, 10% chance for a 400 to 500, and a 25% chance for a 300 to 600, at, like, the level 97 mark. And then those percentages, for you know, increase further for the high end at level 128, and then I guess again at, like, 156 or something.
Like, instead of just rating it that way, they should be rating nodes and things like those fancy ammo boxes and the military drops should have a higher percentage chance. Like, even functioning the way you're just describing, just with those scales, whereas, you know, you can have high quality nodes, medium quality nodes, and low quality nodes. Low quality nodes would be what the most basic thing is. Like, you're not finding anything good out of a low quality node until you're
like
really high level.
Like trash or something, yeah.
Right. And then for each quality of the node, there would be a slightly different ratio. Like, you could still prohibit plus 500 or plus 400 items, but, you know, if I'm opening a gun chest that I just dug through with a fucking stone axe, which I would never do, but you get the point, then it shouldn't be, you know, 1 to 100 stuff. No one's gotten in there. It should be a little bit better quality. Just from the quality of the node.
And I have seen, and it just made me die a bit on the inside. I wandered across a house in a dedicated server, found a gun safe that somebody had looted, but left, you know, stuff inside. It was all level 50 or below gun parts. Like, how does that even... You know?
Yeah, I'm with you.
You know, one thing you could also...
The crafting part is totally solid. They just need to solidify the scavenging part. And the combat. Because, like, you've been talking about archery, it's absurd. And you get no XP for zombie kills. I'm not going to encourage people to farm zombies, but for God's sake, you should get something for zombie kills.
Or you just have your archery skill give, you know, like you said, actually scale up at a better rate, so you get XP from that instead of the kills. And then that's also a way to say, you know, okay, great, you've mastered the bow, you have 100 archery, now use a different weapon for a change. Actually experiment with different things, and you can keep getting XP that way. I think that would be perfectly fine, right?
Yeah, for day one, I feel like the skills, looking at day one and what you're capable of, all base skills, so maybe not gun crafting or iron armor crafting, but all basic starting skills should be able to be leveled up equivalently by the end of day one. And that means you really have to counterbalance things like maybe I literally just run around the whole day to level up my athleticism. That doesn't seem like a good choice, but maybe somebody could really make that work.
The
you know?
Only potential argument I might be mustering against that is that for day one, if you're already trying to, you know, collect the arrow materials and then craft the bows and such, I'm not sure we really want to say that if you go around shooting zombies all day that by the end of day one, archery should be equivalent to everything else, just because you start off with, like, no ammunition, right? You have to gather them in the first place. Now, if you wind up stocked on ammunition for day two, right, and you go around all of day two fully ready from the get-go with a bow and arrows ready, you know, plenty of them to last the entire day, then yeah, you know, you should be able to, like, skill that up if you do nothing but zombie hunt.
Then that's fine. I mean, I don't really think anybody would purely just run around or just do archery. Because, like you said, on day one, you can get lucky, I guess, and maybe end up with 150 arrows, which will probably keep you for the day, but...
But you can't go hunting, you know, 300 zombies day one. You just don't have the ammo. And you don't have the medical supplies to make up for melee hits. Yeah, that too. Alright, so tomorrow... So that tunnel, we can probably, tomorrow night, work on getting set up to the surface. And we are just making our way back to home base here. Belatedly, admittedly. I'm just gonna at least get back to the depths of my base, and then we'll stop the video. We've dug quite a bit of a way, haven't we? Alright, day 20 coming up next.